Taking a look at the energy markets today, I want to focus on WTI. WTI realizing further downside momentum today. We're looking at new lows for 2020 as we continue to see WTI pushing lower after the reaction a week and a half ago to the attacks on the Iraqi military installations. We're seeing significant selling pressure, and really the focus is now shifting back on that supply storyline. There's been no meaningful or significant interference with the current supply situation. There was concerns about the supply coming out of the Middle East, and that has really not been disrupted. Also, we continue to see Iranian oil, you know, not being too significant as far as the supply chain of the crude space, and I think that's another dynamic that's being priced into the market. And a third thing is the non-OPEC producers continuing to ratchet up supply. And when you look at the shale producers here in the United States, now that we're seeing oil getting back up to levels, we're seeing rig counts coming back online. And I can tell you, last year, when you look at just the year-over-year increase in exportation of U.S. oil overseas, continuing to ramp up significantly. And again, I think that's another factor that's playing into the pricing structure within the WTI space. Looking at the current technicals within the space, I think, you know, we certainly have broken down from that uptrend that was well established in December. Now breaking through some levels, and you have to go back to November to see these levels. And I think if we break through 58, and we're holding just above there today, right around the 58.05 level, that 57 is really the next stopping ground with any kind of meaningful support. And then from there, really the next bottom would be the lows from November, where we established twice during the November time period, where we saw WTI get down to that $55 a barrel level. So once again, as we move into 2020, we're seeing further selling pressure on WTI as we start out the week.